Rangers, this is Mystic C from Magic Wands Tarot, and this is your weekly pick a card reading for the week of 12th to the 18th of April. Yes, friends, for the week of 12th to the 18th April. Yes, finally, we are progressing into April. Yes, this is a charms reading, friends, and before we begin, please do subscribe, like and share our channel, friends. Please do subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. We work very, very hard every day to bring you these readings. So please do subscribe, like and share. And do join us on Instagram as Magic Wands Tarot. And to buy a personal reading, visit our website www.magicwandstarot.com. So let's take a deep breath and relax. Choose pile one. This beautiful bus, look at this, it's pretty, isn't it? This red bus. Pile two. The scooter. It is nice, it's cute. Pile three, the car. Where are you going, friends? I have chosen these because we are in quarantine, so I know you must be missing your travel and going out, so it's a reminder for that. So pile 1, pile 2, pile 3. I will leave the timestamps in the comment section below, friends, like always, so you can directly move there and choose your option. Also, friends, you can choose more than one pile if you feel most drawn towards that, more than one. And friends, you can watch the entire video also if you want to. So yes, friends, let us see for those who chose option number one. Let us see what is coming your way, what is next in your love life this week. And yes, it's a charms reading. First we are going to look in your cards, then the charms. So for those who chose option number one, this beautiful bus, let us see. I will keep this card here. I hope you can see it. I think so, you can. Perfect. So your romance angel's messages, we're gonna look at the end. Oh my god, 13, the release. The high priestess, number two. The princes of summer, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, the four of spring, lovely. Queen of Winter, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, and the Magician, wonderful. You have emotions are running high, the Super Moon, interesting, that's an interesting combination for sure. And the Higher Power, number 4. I see that number 2, number 4, number 13 is also 4. So number 2, 4, 22, 13, 31 are important for you this week, or they are your birthday sun signs. I feel some of you also have your birthdays, or someone you know has a birthday coming up. I definitely feel that. I feel a Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person and a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces person will be important for you this week. Also, friends, I feel like, you know, maybe you are Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, friends. I feel this is a week, you know, you have three major arcanas here. So look at this. This is a very important week for you. You have 1, you have 2, and then you have 13. So definitely this is a powerful week. So let's see how this week will be. I would say, you know, this will be a powerful week for you. You are manifesting many, many things in your life. You are working and connecting with yourself, with your power, with your, you know, with your manifestations, whether it is love, job, career, you are connecting with yourself, with your power, and it is empowering for you. I also feel this week will bring you a new start, but first you need to let go of something. If you are trying to manifest love or make a relationship better in your life, I feel something needs to end, something bad needs to end so that something good can start, maybe in that same relationship or in a new one. We'll see with the charm, so don't worry about it. We'll get into detail here. I definitely feel you are working on long-term plans this week. You know, this week is not just about this week for you. This is like long-term plans. You are making 5 years, 3 years plans, or what you will do in the long term in your love life or your education. Or your career also. I definitely feel you are going to, if you are a student, you are going to really work very, very hard, study more, or you will feel very intuitive about your studies, or you know what you need to study. I definitely feel some of you may be getting closer to your exams, or even though we are in quarantine right now, but I do feel you should continue studying, because there might be exams coming up for you, or a new job if you are trying for that. An interview call may come out of the blue, not this week but in the weeks to come ahead. So stay prepared, friends, stay prepared. This week you need to focus on your intuition, your higher knowledge, higher purpose, all those things. You will be also reading more. I feel some of you could also be waiting. I will go into the love just a second. I definitely feel you are reading a lot of books or watching a lot of Netflix. I would suggest you to watch something which is helpful, like on some documentary or something. I think it will be really, really helpful for you, and it will bring you some important information that you need for your love life or your career or your education. I also feel you definitely need to release something. You know, I feel let go of the past and ending that makes way for new opportunities. Time to move on. I feel you are in double minds regarding a relationship, friends. I definitely feel like you have moved on from someone. There has been an ending in a relationship or a friendship, but still, you know, a part of you is lingering there. You are gentle, you are romantic, and you kind of want, you still love that person, but you are still like, you know, what is happening? That person might be not in communication with you, but you still have a very strong telepathic connection with that person, and that bond is going to deepen this week, and you are going to feel a lot of emotions because you do have the card of emotions are running high, the super moon. And we have, once when this week ends, we will have a new moon in Taurus, and sun will be moving into Taurus right at the end of this week, 19th, and a new moon around the 22nd, I think, if I'm correct, or around the 19th it is. So definitely, you know, your emotions are running high. I think this full moon was also important for you, the one we had in Libra around the 7th of April. So I feel the March full moon was also important for you. Something may have happened in March. I feel, you know, if you are married, you will have to release some negativity or judgments regarding your husband, your wife, maybe an ex-husband or wife. You need to release the judgments related to them. If you are single, someone has hurt you in the past, and some sort of a negativity or some hurt or pain still lingering around you. So you need to release it, because you are right on the path of manifesting an amazing relationship, a marriage, and you are also manifesting a great career for yourself. You are right there. You are on the perfect path. You do not need to doubt. I think some of you may be doubting whether you are on the right path or not in this week. I have to tell you, you are on the right path, and I definitely feel communications are coming your way or will be coming your way. If you are waiting for news from a person or want to hear from a person you lost touch with, maybe 3-4 years or maybe 3-4 months back, you lost touch with a connection with someone, that person will be coming back. It could be a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, or an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini person, friends. Definitely messages are going to come, and they may trigger some emotions in you, some worry, some anxiety, but I definitely feel you know, there will be happiness and there will be a lot of joy. I definitely feel maybe you you know, thoughts of marriage, getting settled down, moving in with someone. If you are alone in this quarantine, you may be realizing the importance of marriage, or what is the importance of having a partner around, or what home means to you. All those things are important. Be grateful. You have much to celebrate. Deep feelings of love and peace and happiness. a contented personal life. So see, I'm telling you this thing that something beautiful is going to manifest for you, even though you are going to say, oh, it's a quarantine. How are we going to meet someone? How can we fall in love? Darlings, my dear darlings, you need to read the book Love in the Times of Cholera. In great epidemics, the greatest and the most beautiful love stories happen. So if you doubt this, I would say don't, because you should try. If you are manifesting, go ahead and manifest. Keep manifesting that job, that career. You are on the right path. Just don't worry about so much. I feel your emotions will be very high, whether you are a student, or whether you are, you know, no matter what you do or where you are in life, single, married, couple, student, job, whatever, your emotions will be high. So you do need to, you know, settle down on your emotions a bit, stay calm a bit, follow your intuition, I say. And definitely communications will be coming, and new friendships can happen through online dating, through because we have more time now. So definitely relationships are more favorable now, so definitely chance of meeting someone or reuniting with someone is extremely high. But you need to release something from the past. A higher power, number four, definitely this is a fated connection. A twin flame connection is coming, and if you are in a twin flame connection, you are going to feel very attached to them. Even if you do not message them, talk to them regularly, you will be getting signs, messages, and their emotions also. And even if you are not in a twin flame, you are going to miss someone or feel someone's energy around you, your lover, your husband, your ex-husband, wife, whatever, someone you love, you someone you really really love, you are going to feel their emotions. And they might call you also, and they might want to return, or you might call someone and want to have a talk with them. Let us see your romance angels messages. Past life connections, you have known each other before, absolutely. So definitely issues from the past life will be active in this week. So you need to follow your intuition, keep your emotions in check, and balance your chakras. I say drink more water, and you know, walk barefoot on the grass, or maybe in your house on the ground. So it's nice to keep you grounded. Let's see your charms so that we can find more details about who is the person coming your way. Let's see that. So pile number one for the week of 12 to the 18th of April, angels. What's going to happen? Oh, wow. See, you got this. So definitely health is important and well-being is important. It could be health of a family member or a lover or a loved one is on your mind. If you have children, that is important for you. You are worried about them. It could also be that some of you are looking for expanding your family or something, like having kids and all. Maybe some of you are expecting, so that also will go well if you are looking in that area. So let's see, news from far, aeroplane, and we have chosen the bus and we have the aeroplane. So yeah, news from far is coming definitely for you. Let us see your letters. There is H, there is G, and there is B. If we had a U, it would have been a hug. But H, B, G, and HB reminds me of also hemoglobin. So I would suggest you to eat proper and do not worry at all, friends. You are absolutely guided. You have nothing to worry about, and just keep check on your emotions. You may feel some anxiety, health worries definitely. You see how this keeps on moving. So this is the moon charm here. So definitely your thoughts will fluctuate a lot and your moods may swing a lot this week. So stay calm, friends, stay calm. I'm gonna keep it there so it doesn't rotate. 10 of air, something is ending and a new beginning is coming. 3 of cups, definitely celebrations are coming your way, friends. Maybe some of you will connect with old friends or a new lover, or something will happen that will make you happy. Maybe a past relationship is coming back towards you, that is going to make you happy. What else is here? The Queen of Wands, and Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person might be important for you. Eagle, so that's what I'm telling you. You know, this is the week where you take a very strong, you know, this is an important week, friends. Even though you may say like, I do not see anything happening in this week. I know. Oh, but it is an important week, because I would say what happens this week will bring you long-term results. So watch it and note down things in your diaries this week, and come back and let me know what happened. Because definitely eagles are about higher perspective, long-term plannings, and they are very strong, and they are about intuition, whale. So I definitely feel whales are, you know, they are another very powerful totem. So definitely you need something fated is going to happen, and they, and something, you know, whales are also about in water, so they also connect with emotions. So some emotional healing will happen for you this week. Six of fear, definitely worries are ending for you, and new positive start is there. One of wands, ace of wands. Definitely you also have the magician. Whatever you want in your career, if you might be stressed about money, probably I feel it's going to work out. You don't need to be so stressed about money or career. The locked, you know, the heart lock is here, so someone has their heart fixed on you. Absolutely, this, you can see this, you know, they have their heart fixed on you, and they, this person will be coming towards you. Number 18, number 13, number 2, 4, 18, 13, 31 is important. Flower, you may propose someone or message someone, or someone else will message you. This leaf is about letting go of worries, extra thoughts, and all those things. That's it for now, friends. Please do subscribe, like, and share our channel. Friends, please do subscribe if you enjoyed this reading. And do join us on Instagram as Magic Wens Tarot. To buy a personal reading, visit our website, friends. I am running very late on personal orders, so please be kind. I told you I will be finishing up, and then only I will be booking new orders. So thank you so much for your patience. I know you all have been very, very supportive and kind. Thank you so much. Because there is a lot of work because of the quarantine and all those things. So yeah, the scooter, if you chose this beautiful scooter, let us see how this week will be from the 12th to the 18th of April for you, your romance angels messages. We're gonna also look at the charms. Wow, the wheel of fortune, number 10, right on the spot we are. The 9 of springs, the 4 of summer, the 5 of summer, oh god, and the 3 of pentacles in reversed. Goodness me. Bring love into the situation. New moon in Aquarius. Okay. To the sea. And mending, the number 52. Wonderful. So I feel like, you know, firstly, I feel that an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius person will be important to you this week. Or you are an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. I also feel you could be a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, friends. So I feel this week, you know, this week you are going to feel like, you know, disappointed in some way, like life is slow, nothing is happening, this quarantine may hit you. Sorry to say, but you know, things feel like, you know, this, you might feel slightly unhappy this week, or slightly sad. I also feel you will feel like something is missing out of your life, like you are not lucky, or you may feel slightly pessimistic about your life this week, or you may be waiting for a lover or some job or career to come towards you, and you feel like you had waited a long time but it is not happening. Maybe you are waiting for a relationship or a lover from past 5 years, 3 years, 2 years, 1 year, or you are waiting for a job since a long, long time, and it may hurt you and worry you and make you sad this week. But why things are not working out for me? Why do I have to wait for things? You may also, especially if you are in a love relationship, or with family members, you may feel like others are not cooperating with you, or you are, you know, they are not understanding your opinions or ideas, they do not respect you, or there is this feeling of non-cooperation happening around you, or a lack of. I also feel some of you have changed, you know, some of you may be changing very, very quickly, like you are spiritually growing, so your friends, you cannot resonate, you no longer resonate with your friends who used to be your friends. So that may cause you sadness. You might feel slightly lonely this week. But also if you are waiting for a lover, if you are already in a relationship, I feel a lover may really be, you know, they might be busy at work or more focused on themselves. So they might be a little away from you or not much in touch with you. So that might lead to you feeling sad. And you might also feel like, oh, this lockdown, this quarantine is so boring. I'm just so tired of this, all this going on in my life. Why is this happening? I would tell you not to give up, because you are right on the path and on a breakthrough, or a miracle is coming. Look what the card is saying. Protect the fruits of your labor, prepare for possible challenges that lie ahead, environmental conservation. So definitely, friends, I would suggest you not to give up, because this is followed by the wheel. So you are very, very close to a breakthrough in your relationship. You should not give up on it. And in your career also, even if things are slow right now, they will pick up, and you should not give up. Keep walking, keep working hard and planning your your career. I also feel in your education also, you might be feeling like, there is a lack of motivation. What do I study? When is the exams going to happen? Keep studying, don't give up. Study what you enjoy, because the wheel is here, so something is going to move forward in your life. And I feel there is, you are waiting for something to move forward. I feel it is both in work, love and career. So you are waiting for some things to move ahead, and that will happen for you by the end of this week. So you are right there. Do not give up now, and do not be pessimistic. Things, delays are over. Sudden or unexpected good luck, a new car or travel is coming. So definitely things are going to move forward in your love life, in your career, in your marriage also, in your education. But you should, that will only happen when you do not give up. You also have the card, bring love into a situation, new moon in Aquarius. So you may be dealing with an Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or a Virgo or Taurus person, or you are these sun signs. I feel like, you know, you feel like you just keep giving and giving, but someone is not giving you back. I feel things will change this week for you. You know, the turn will happen, like the wheel turning, and now you will be on the receiving end of the blessing. So don't worry. Some things will mend for you, definitely. Number 52, something will be mending, some relationships, some friendships. If you have lost contact with a friend, or if you had a falling out or a quarrel or an argument with a friend, things are going to work out for you. And I feel like this is someone going to call you, phone call you, or give you a text message or an email or something, and it's going to make things move forward in your life. I also feel like, you know, to the sea, number 7, definitely, you know, you feel like you are really, really, someone is really missing you. Either you are missing them or they are missing you. I feel someone else is missing you this week, some lover or someone, or maybe, you know, you are missing your own family, like, you know, people who are not with you right now, those who have passed away, your friends, or anyone who has passed away, someone from there you are missing. But I feel, you know, you are going to get better. Things will get better. They are always, you know, there is not much difference here and there. How do I say this? Sometimes it's hard to explain these things on a video. I feel there is someone on your mind, and someone is also thinking about you, and you may feel the distance between you and this person, or this opportunity, like this job, you feel like, oh, this is so far away, how will I get that job? Maybe some of you want to go abroad for studies, and now because of the world situation you are disheartened. Don't be disheartened, friends. There are always solutions, so something good will happen, and some new, some forward momentum is definitely going to happen. And I would suggest you to keep your motivation very high, your passion very high this week, and do not go in the energy of being pessimistic. Let's see your romance angel's message. Attraction, you attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. See? This moment fully, enjoying this moment fully. So this week, enjoy, take some time to spend with yourself. I feel some of you may be still working from home, or you have a lot of things to do right now. So you might also get that thing like, what is going on? I am not happy. Where is this lover? Why people are not drawn towards me? I think, you know, people are really drawn towards you. You just need to change your perspective about something and share your thoughts, because the wheel is here. So definitely something is going to happen, and some forward progress is going to happen in your career also and your love life also. So don't give up. Let's see your charms, friends. For pile number 2, what are their charms for the week from 12 to 18? Wow, again this card. See, the heart is here. Someone is very fond of you, friends, and you are also very, very fond of someone. You know, they love you, they miss you, they also care for you. If that is your question, yes, you can also check the other pick a card reading I recently did. Who is in love with you? It might help you. So check that out also, friends. We have the number 5. So positive changes are coming your way. See, we have the dice here. We also have pineapple. Focus on the sweetness of life, friends. Don't focus on the hardships or how long the wait has been, why it has been like that. You know, life has a plan. God has a plan. Sometimes if your will does not happen and God's will happen, that means it is for the best of everybody. You have the letter F, so that might be important. You got very less charms as well, most. For pile number 2. Oh my God. This one dropped right out of my hand on the table. The N, I don't know why I said 9, maybe 9, number 9 is important for you. Number F, there is the letter F, there is the letter N, there is the T here. So definitely some things are brewing. The teapot is here. Something is brewing in your life which you cannot see right now, but which will come towards you later on. So good things are going to happen. Don't be so pessimistic. This is the card about charm, about mood swings. You see how this bead is layered. So definitely mood swings. I also see this as the, how you say, as the light coming in, you know, luck coming in after a long wait. I also feel you might be worried about a third party situation happening, or you know, someone has put you in a third party. Or you just feel like if someone is not communicating with you, they might be in a third party or something. I feel people are just focusing on themselves right now, and that might be an issue. And you might be, you know, you might also need to take some time for yourself and rest. Teapots are also about taking some time, relaxing, enjoying life. You have the dog, so there is someone is very loyal to you, and you don't have to worry about it. And you also are very loyal to someone. 10 of air. Definitely you feel like, you know, you are working very, very hard this week, so you need some rest. Take care and rest, don't hurry too much. Neptune, definitely, you know, Neptune is also like the karmic planet and also the planet of emotions also. So there are a lot of hidden emotions coming out this week for you. You know, like some past disappointment either in love, work or career or education may come. out suddenly for you, but don't worry, you have the luck with you and things are moving forward. And we have the Eight of Wands, so definitely, you know, this is also about not giving up and finding, you know, not just don't give up this week, friends. Just don't. You are very close to something very exciting in your life. All the problems are going to be ironed out of your life, so don't worry. Peace is going to come in your life, and I also see this as a celebration coming your way. Your old friends or someone you are very fond of is going to meet you or unite with you again. And you have the green card, so it is about healing and focusing on health and yourself. Letter F and N are important also. So that's it for now, friends. Please do subscribe, like and share our channel. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I know many of you are watching but not subscribing. Very, 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 very bad of you. It's all right, friends, if you don't subscribe. Many, many blessings to you either ways. And join us on Instagram as Magic Wens Tarot. To buy a personal reading, visit our website www.magicwenstarot.com. So for those who chose option number 3, this beautiful car, look at this, so cute. Let us see how your week will be from 12th to the 18th of April. Your romance angels, we're gonna look at it in the end. Oh wow, life experience number 16, the Emperor, wonderful, the Ego, oh my god, Major Arcanas, 3 right off, Ace of Wands, very nice, 8 of Autumn, 9 of Autumn, you got more cards, friends, one extra, Princes of Spring, okay, I hope you can see the cards. Let us see what else is here. A new romantic cycle begins for you. New moon in Libra. Adjustments are required. Third quarter moon. And by the book. Wonderful. 11-11. So definitely there is a twin flame connection important to you, friends, in this week. Or you are going to meet your twin flame. If you don't know your twin flame, first thing I'm getting, because you have 1, 2, 3. And Major Arcanas and one new beginning, Ace of Wands. A passionate new start is coming or going to happen for you or for someone you know in your life. First and foremost, I feel an Aries Leo Sagittarius person or a Capricorn Virgo Taurus person is important to you, or you are these sun signs. I also feel an Aquarius Libra person can also be important, or you are an Aquarius Libra yourself, friends. I feel there will be a tower movement either in your life, sorry to say that, but I have to say what I am seeing in the cards. You know, some tower movement will happen either in you, in your life, or with a partner, or I am feeling like it is going to happen in a person you are dealing with. It could be in a relationship or a past lover, twin flame, or an ex-husband and wife. Someone is going to get a check on their ego. Some false masks are going to be removed. Someone's ego is going to be shattered, and that person could be quite dominating, they could be quite controlling, they might be very reserved. I feel you may have a tower movement with that person, or you had a tower movement with that person, but I feel someone in your life may have a tower movement, and that is going to cause their ego to break a little, and their heart is going to shine out. You see this heart there, someone's heart is going to shine out because of a quarrel or an argument. I also feel you may cry a little this week, or you may suddenly feel like crying this week out of the blue, just for the heck of it. So you may feel like, you know, you may remember a person or someone is already near you, and you may have a fight or argument, and you may cry about that person. Sorry to say, but it's there. But you know, this is going to be a positive thing for you because a new start is going to happen, a passionate new connection is going to happen, or something is going to be revealed which is going to help you feel passionate and motivated in your life. I am feeling that. I also feel someone may have a tower moment in their life. And that will be that their ego will be released or removed or healed, and their emotions will come out. And that person might start or contact you for a new start in the you know, with you in love and relationship. I also feel if you are in student and you know, if you are studying and waiting for opportunities, or you were like, I am a leader, why I have to wait and all this thing, you know. I definitely feel you should keep working hard because you might not be expecting exams are going to happen, or that education, higher education thing will happen because of the current world situation. But I would say stay prepared because it may happen even without in a different way. Like, you know, stay prepared. I would say if you are a student, exams may happen or the dates may be coming very quickly. So you should prepare now rather than later on when there is less time. I also feel some of you could be feeling very challenged regarding your work situation. So some of you could be thinking about leaving your job, or you know, financial situations are worrisome. So I would say that, you know, some of you could be thinking about joining or starting your own work, your own business, your creative ideas. You know, like maybe you want to make something, you are good at crafts or selling something, you know, making some items or something, maybe chocolates or food, or you know, maybe you can be a good chef also. So some of you are going to rediscover those things about yourself. And this is going to come by, you know, this is going to happen suddenly for you this week, so it might surprise you a little. I also feel be careful because if you are with a husband or wife, or with your elderly parents, you might have an argument with them because, you know, you are feeling very strong, you are feeling very, very powerful this week. You want, like, oh, I am in the charge of everything, so that can happen. So be careful about it. And also optimistic, enthusiasm, creative and energetic. That's the energy for you. And no wonder you chose this red car, a passionate new start and a passion. And a passionate new start in your career is also coming, you know, and your education is also coming. So stay connected for that. And adjustments are required. Yeah, you are going to find something either in your love life, a new relationship, or a past connection is coming back. Someone you had a fight with, that person is going to reunite, and a new start will happen. But you know, whatever will happen this week, you need to adjust something. You know, adjustments are required. You may not want to adjust to someone or something or some situation. That is why you may face a tower moment. But I think adjustments are sometimes good. Don't say the word adjustment. I would say be flexible. That's better. You know, be flexible this week. Don't be too much of a leader because the tower is right here. So don't be too much of a leader. And definitely a new romantic cycle is beginning for you. New moon in Libra, so justice is going to happen. If someone has done you wrong and you were like, oh my god, why did that happen, and all those things, something new will happen this week and maybe this month, and it is going to put you back in the romance cycle, in your luck and career also. So that, stay tuned for that. You know, doing things by the book, you know, 11-11. So I definitely feel you have till now been doing things by your mind or by your, as people were telling you. But this week you are going to break free. You know, you don't want to hear what others say, you don't want to be a follower. A leader is emerging from you, friends. You are going to be a leader and you know, independent. Even if you are a woman, you may suddenly realize that you need to work and be financially independent. You have an idea that can earn you money, so go for it. Don't do things by the book, but stay flexible because you need to be flexible this week. I also feel there might be a twin flame relationship or an important relationship which was going, but traditionally or which was not working for you, but now things can get passionate and, you know, steamy hot this week for you. Let's see your romance angels chemistry. There is a strong magnetic attraction here. So definitely, you know, someone has a lot of feelings for you, friends, and that person or that connection is coming back. And I think someone has been sleeping or not sharing their feelings about you. That person will have a tower moment or a realization and they are going to share their feelings. Let's see the charms. Option number 3. What are their charms? For option number 3. Ooh, you got lots of charms. See? You got the aeroplane, so definitely news is coming your way, friends, from far. Someone at a distance is thinking about you and they want a new start with you. There is the letter G here, there is the letter L here and O here. You have a lot of letters. There is F also. There is S also. So loss, maybe loss is like, you know, or gloss is important, like put some gloss, like lip gloss, and feel like, you know, a princess. Oh my god, you have the crown here. I'll get to it, just a second. I was just checking what charms you have. I wanted to keep them face upside. All right. So definitely, you know, G, L, O, S, and F and V are important. So you can make words out of it if you can, like gloss is there, loss is there. So some loss, you may have thought you lost something, but I think something better will be coming your way. You are the queen or the king, so don't worry about it. And you know, you are going to handle any situation or stress that happens this week like a king or a queen. You are on the path of becoming a queen or a king. Number 20 might be important, number 26 might be important, number 99 might be important, or number 19 might be important as your birth date or something. This is about staying. This is an or a yellow card. I feel you should stay positive, friends, and optimistic about things in your life. And this is the bouquet. So some sort of a good news is going to come your way. Someone is going to offer you some proposal or some flowers, or maybe, you know, some of you could start your own things, like own profession, like I told you, cake decorating, chef, pastry making, or maybe you are into designing, textiling work, all those things, writing, poetry, anything, you know. You also have the one of coins, so ace of pentacles. You also have the ace of wands here, so new beginnings are a theme. You again have Neptune, so the pile 2 also had it. Neptune is about you know, breakthroughs. It is about whatever is not working falls away and what is important comes to light. And Saturn, fated connections, fated. This is an important week, friends. You should watch out this week. And what else is there? Four of coins. Definitely, I would say that do not overspend your money, because you have the four of coins and you also have the tower here. So hold on to your money. Don't be extravagant just because, you know, sometimes we get tempted. Eight of coins. We also have the eight of coins here. That is why I love the charm. See, we pull the charm and we also have the card here. So definitely you are working hard, and especially if you are a student, you should keep working, because you may get a surprise, you know, like an exam date coming quickly or something like that. Or so, you know, keep working, don't quit. And Queen of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces person. So that might be important. Emotions are high this week for everyone, but you are on the path of becoming a queen or a king, or someone is going to share their feelings. towards you who is at a distance. So that's it for now, friends. Please do subscribe, like and share our channel. I know many watch but don't subscribe, you break my heart, but okay, that's okay. Angel's blessings. I know so many of you subscribe and you win my heart, friends. I love you all so much, and thank you so much. Do join us on Instagram as Magic Wens Tarot. To buy a personal reading, visit our website www.magicwenstarot.com. This is Mystic C saying bye for now.